Hey guys, remember this morning, one of the main things I was trying to get across to you in a message that they've had more deaths just from this last winter season just with the general flu. They've had approximately 12,000 deaths. They've only had a hair over 2,000 deaths with the recent coronavirus. They didn't put a huge emphasis on the amount of deaths that they did with the flu, but yet they are with the coronavirus, okay? What I'm trying to tell you is when the markets, or when the rate change occurs, the U.S. financial markets are going to spike up, jump, and dance. Okay? The markets were already too high. They were risking inflation. So they had to bring the markets back down as a correction by the excuse of the coronavirus. So when that rate changes, the markets can shoot back up to where they just came from. Here's your banking news.
The central bank issues a brochure of the foreign currency sales window for 2019. February 24, 2020. The Central Bank of Iraq issued a brochure entitled, The Window for Selling Foreign Currency in the Central Bank of Iraq, which clarifies the administrative framework for financing imports and the mechanism of selling foreign currency to banks in covering their customers' requests, and the process of collecting and sterilizing the local currency considering that this bank represents the monetary authority in Iraq. The Central Bank of Iraq. Information Office 224-2020. The central bank clarifies the administrative framework for financing imports and the mechanism for selling foreign currencies. February 25, 2020, the Iraqi Central Bank issued, on Tuesday, a brochure entitled The Window for Selling Foreign Currency in the Central Bank of Iraq. The brochure explains the administrative framework for financing imports and the mechanism of selling foreign currency to banks in covering the requests of their customers, the bank said in a statement. He added, it also clarifies the process of collecting and sterilizing the local currency considering that this bank represents the monetary authority in Iraq. The Arab Monetary Fund announces the launch of the BUNA payment platform. The platform serves to enhance opportunities for financial integration and to support economic and investment ties with the trading partners of Arab countries. February 23, 2020. The Arab Monetary Fund AMF is pleased to announce the launch of BUNA, the regional payment platform, as a culmination of months of planning and collaboration with global and regional stakeholders. BUNA, which is a multi-currency payment platform, provides clearing and settlement services in Arab and international currencies that meet the eligibility criteria related to the clearing and settlement of inter-Arab financial transactions, as well as transactions between Arab countries and their main trading partners. BUNA, as a centralized multi-currency platform, aims to enable financial institutions, including commercial and central banks, to send and receive cross-border payments across the Arab region and beyond in Arab currencies, as well as key international currencies, in an efficient, cost-effective, risk-controlled and transparent environment. BUNA offers its participants a state-of-the-art payment platform compliant with international standards. In fact, bringing BUNA to reality constitutes a major, tangible and irreversible step towards the empowerment and integration of Arab economies. The launch of BUNA signals the start of the gradual onboarding operations of financial institutions that have opted to be pioneers of this first-of-its-kind regional financial market infrastructure, aiming to process the first payment transaction in a few weeks. On this occasion, His Excellency Dr. Abdulrahman Al-Hamidi, Director General and Chairman of the Board of Executive Directors of the Arab Monetary Fund, expressed his gratitude and appreciation of the strategic launch of the platform, which aims to encourage and develop Arab financial activities, commercial trade and cross-border investments. The system aims to promote trade relations and develop investment activities between the Arab countries and providing an environment that facilitates the development of financial and banking services and products in the region. His Excellency also expressed his sincere appreciation and gratitude to the governors of the central banks and Arab monetary institutions, the Board of Governors of the Fund and its Board of Directors for their efforts in supporting the platform's inauguration. His Excellency especially expressed his gratitude to the United Arab Emirates authorities for providing significant reinforcement for the launch of the platform. His Excellency also thanked the central banks, Arab monetary institutions, and the team of experts from the international financial institutions for their continuous cooperation during this implementation phase. The exchange rates of Arab currencies against the Arab account dinar. February 25, 2020. 1 Arab dinar equals $4.09645 Sampson. Kuwait prevents ships coming or heading to 7 countries, including Iraq, from stopping at its ports. February 26, 2020. Kuwait decided, Wednesday, to prevent ships coming or going to China, South Korea, Italy, Singapore, Thailand, Japan and Iraq from stopping at Kuwaiti ports. She explained that ships belonging to the oil sector are excluded from the ban on stopping at Kuwaiti ports. This comes in conjunction with the announcement by the Kuwaiti Ministry of Health earlier Wednesday that 2 new cases of coronavirus had been detected in the country, linked to travel to Iran. A statement of the Ministry of Health stated that the total number of injured Kuwait has reached 11 injured so far. Kuwait had previously announced the suspension of flights to a number of countries that were infected with the coronavirus. The Kuwaiti news agency reported on Tuesday that the Civil Aviation Authority announced the suspension of all flights with Singapore and Japan due to fears of the coronavirus, according to the instructions of the Ministry of Health. On Monday, flights were suspended with South Korea, Iran, Thailand, Italy, and Iraq, as instructed by the Ministry of Health due to concerns over the spread of the coronavirus. It is noteworthy that the first injuries recorded in the country were between 700 who were evacuated on Saturday from the Iranian city of Mashhad. The global markets are entering the quarantine stage. February 26, 2020. Interested in the economic issue expected more losses amid rising concerns about the spread of corona, which pushed oil prices to the lowest level in more than a month, as well as exacerbated global stock losses. Oil prices tumbled about 4%. As the rapid spread of the coronavirus outside China fueled investor concerns about the implications for crude demand. Global stocks also continued to lose in light of growing concerns about the virus, after the number of new cases jumped in Iran, Italy, and South Korea. Magnitude of the risks. Oil prices fell in European exchanges because of the risks that the spread of the coronavirus emerging outside China will affect global demand in a market that is already in surplus. The price of a barrel of Brent North Sea oil for April delivery was $56.05 in London, recording a decrease of 4.19% compared to the closing price at the end of the week. In New York, the West Texas Intermediate barrel for the same month's delivery lost 3.97% to $51.26, shortly after reaching $51.24, a decrease of 4.19%. This significant price drop ends yesterday, Monday, with higher prices Barclay Brent and Light Oil, which reached 2% and 10%, respectively. Last week, since resuming its rise on February 10th, OPEC is currently awaiting market activists from member states of the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, and its allies who will meet next week in Vienna to try to secure a response to the oversupply, which is the size of the risks currently faced by demand. China has indefinitely postponed the annual meeting of its parliament due to the emerging coronavirus, in a rare change in the Chinese system's events that are organized and normally run smoothly. The work of the People's National Assembly was scheduled to open on the 5th of next March, as every year. In one of the meetings that highlight the country's unity with the red flags in which it is raised and the decisions that are taken almost unanimously. However, the appearance of the new coronavirus, which has infected thousands of people and killed 2,500 many of the infected, has changed the schedule. The National Assembly seemed to gather 3,000 deputies in the Great Hall of the People in Beijing is out of the question while a part of the country is still under quarantine. While a large part of the Chinese live under strict quarantine measures or are hiding in their homes for fear of infection and not coming out without masks, parliamentary official Zhuang Ziyaoyi admitted last week that postponing this year's session was necessary in order to focus attention on preventing and controlling the epidemic. Growth may experience a noticeable decline in 2020 due to the severe slowdown in the economy about a month ago due to the spread of the virus. Gulf stock exchanges also ended the end of their dealings on a collective retreat after the announcement of cases of Arab countries, particularly Oman, Kuwait, and Bahrain. The emergence of cases of the emerging Chinese virus. And he expected that the world gold prices would witness record increases until he exceeded $1,700 an ounce, the highest level for this most active contract since February 2013. To avoid corona, calls for sterilization of banknotes in Iraq. February 26, 2020. A member of the Iraqi Economic Council, Kadir Al-Attar, called on Wednesday to start precautionary measures on the Iraqi and foreign currency to prevent the transmission of the coronavirus. The People's Bank of China has subjected sterilization and stone banknotes to fight the coronavirus, Al-Attar said in a statement. Al-Attar pointed out that the Iraqi Central Bank and Iraqi banks work using ultraviolet radiation or very high temperatures to sterilize banknotes, before isolating them for a period ranging between 7 and 14 days to prevent the spread of the coronavirus through banknotes. And the member of the Economic Council said, the relevant authorities must maintain the safety and health of the users of cash flow in Iraq.